If you are interested in all things French reading, French books is a great way to expand your vocabulary and your knowledge of French culture. But finding a solid recommendation can be difficult, and that's why I know lots of students turn to the classics such as Les Misérables, or they read a French translation of an English book they like, because they don't know what else to read. Let's broaden your horizon with modern recommendations, so you can enjoy the Francophone literature that French people are reading, like me. Allow me to introduce you to some of my favorite books that I read this year. I'm going to talk about a lot of books and even more than just books, so I put the links to all of them in my blog post for today's lesson. You will find the link below this video if you're watching on YouTube. Let's start with the page turners. The first one I want to recommend that I just finished a few days ago is Née d'aucune femme de Franck Bouys. This one was very surprising because it's been in my Amazon recommendation list for a long time. I was seeing it everywhere. And I don't know why, I was not very attracted, but I started and it was amazing. It's about a young woman in the something like 19th century who is sold into slavery in France to a rich landlord by her dad. I won't tell you much more, but you just can't stop. And I remember I was in the cold outside waiting for a friend, and I was on the last pages and I told her, just give me like 2 minutes because I need to know the end. So I did, and the book was absolutely fantastic. I highly recommend it. You can also enjoy these books on an audio form. I use Audible. You're welcome to use any kind of format, but on an audio format, it was absolutely great. The second one that was a recommendation from a friend is Changer l'eau des fleurs by Valérie Perrin. So it's all about a young woman who happens to be the guardian of a cemetery. She takes care of the cemetery and she takes care of the people as well, because she takes care of the tombs, but also of the ceremonies that happens there. She talks to them, she gives some tea. Sometimes she sees people every year and they come back to her, and she's an important point in her life. And we learn more about her story. It's really a page turner again. And I remember texting my friend with, oh no. And she was like, yes, I'm so sorry. Yeah. So there is a big thing in the book that you will tell me about when you're reading it. Email me when you reach this point of pure horror. But it's extremely exciting. And even the ending is warm, because the characters all find closure, and it's extremely, extremely well written, and you enjoy it and you will remember it for a long time. Then we have Couleur de l'incendie. This one was a surprise, because after reading it, I loved it so much that I gave it to my mom as a gift, and I found out she already had it. So that was really funny. And I told her, you already have this, why didn't you tell me? I forgot, so yes, I'm going to read it. So it's a trilogy after, actually, you probably have heard of Au Revoir là-haut, which is the first of the story, but you can read them without knowing about the other two. So Couleur de l'incendie is the second one, and by far my favorite. It happens after World War II, before the Second World War, and it is a young woman who actually is manipulated into losing her money to another member of her family. She has a young son who has a big accident, and she's going to get out of this with him. And it's very exciting, because you're in the middle of the pre-war era, and you can feel that something bad is arriving, and it's all her story in the middle of history, the big history that happening. And then Miroir de nos peines is the third one, and it is about a woman who has to escape during l'exode that we have in France. But this one is not my favorite. The second one, Couleur de l'incendie by Pierre Lemaitre, I absolutely loved it, and I don't even want to see the movie, because I love the book so much that I want to keep this memory in my head. Then we have something that really scared me in a good way. It was Trois jours et une vie by Pierre Lemaitre as well, because I loved the three other books so much that I wanted to read something else from him. So this one is completely different. It's a thriller, and it's the kind of books that puts me in a very uncomfortable way, because I have way too much empathy for fictional characters. That's why there's some TV series or movies that I know my partner tells me, don't watch it because you're going to feel really bad. I'm this kind of person. So for Trois Jours et une Vie, I remember finishing it, I think at 3 a.m. because I wanted to know what happened to the character. I couldn't go to sleep without knowing how it ended. And it's really a page turner, because all things happen at a very quick pace. So it's set up in our times, and it follows the story of a young boy who makes a big mistake by killing another boy. But it's kind of an accident, and we're going to see what happens next. I'm not telling you much more, but it's really that. So if you're in for thrillers, read that. It's really, really, really addictive. But it's also a bit unsettling, because there's something that you would not agree with in terms of his character, but he does it because that's the situation he's in. And you just, I could not stop thinking about it. Then we have something that Penelope Bageux, I saw it's in Penelope Bageux's Twitter feed, because anything that Penelope Bageux recommends or that her audience recommends, I very often buy, because we have very similar tastes. L'Aube sera grandiose is actually a novel by Anne-Laure Bondou that was written for teenagers. And I was very curious into reading this kind of literature. I read a bit in English as well, because I was curious to see what the expectations were, and it was very high quality literature, and I heard that the literature for teenagers is very, very good at the moment. So I read this one, and again, another page turner. It's about a mom who takes her daughter, who is around 16, for a ride at night, and she tells her, I'm going to take you to a family house who is next to a lake, and I'm going to tell you about this big family secret that we have. And because of the title, at the end of the night, so at dawn, she knows everything. So it goes hour by hour, and you find out about the family secret that is huge, and it's very well written, and you read, just you are with the character, and you think of yourself as a teenager. How would you have reacted to that, and how the family reacted as well? So really, really, really good. It's really something that you take with you on a holiday or just a cozy night. There is nothing very shocking. It's very well written, very smooth, and it's up for everybody to read. In a completely different region of the world, because I wanted to explore Francophone literature more widely than just France, I read Les Impatientes by Jaili Amadou Amal, that is about arranged marriage in Cameroon. Great, great story. Three women, we follow their arranged marriage and their life. And again, another page turner. You really have lots of empathy for the three characters and how they're going to interact with each other and their life, and they are the context of their destiny. Really, really, really good. Then we have Soif, very widely known because it is by Amélie Nothomb, who won lots of prizes and publishes one book every year, and she didn't stop. So Soif is great. It's about the story of Jesus Christ. She rewrites what he thought about the sacrifice of giving himself on the cross. And I really loved it. It reminded me a lot of L'Évangile selon Pilate by Eric Emmanuel Schmidt, which is a similar book about thinking about the end of Jesus Christ and the story around it and how they want to be remembered altogether. So I really, really enjoyed it. And I had not read Amélie Nothomb for a long time because, I don't know, I had read a few when I was a teenager and then I stopped. And then I came back because it had Because lots of people were really talking about it, and because I heard on the radio about Premier Sang, her most recent book, and my mom told me that Soif was really good as well, so I read this one, and it was by far my favorite so at the moment. And then the one that I finished last night, it was La Carte Postale by Anne Berest. There are some pages that I had to not read because it was too hard. It's about a family of Jewish people during the Second World War, and some of them were deported and assassinated, and some did not. And it's about the survival of the survivors and their story and the children's story. It is called La Carte Postale because it is about a woman in our time who receives a postcard with the names of the four members of her family who are killed at in the camps. And she doesn't know who sent it. So it's an inquiry about an inquest, enquête, we say in French, about who sent it. But it goes through the whole family. And because it's the truth, there were some just pages that I could not read, but it was a fantastic book. Also about what it is to be Jewish in France in the 21st century, which is extremely interesting. That was the most interesting part, beyond the story of each character, because she tells about the constant threat that is around her, and that was fascinating. So this is the page turners. They can be read by everybody. You don't need any kind of knowledge into French culture or any particular interest in a moment in time. Then in terms of more different books that I loved this year, we have Honoré et moi by Titu Lecoq. Oh my God, I had heard about this for such a long time. I don't know why I did not read it earlier. It's a biography of Honoré de Balzac, who is one of the most famous French writers. But because he's the kind of writer you learn at school and you're forced to read, I had this preconceived notion that he was boring. He was not. And the biography is absolutely mind-blowing. You just discover such a fantastic character and you want to read his books. And I have not so far, but there were two of his books that were adapted into movies recently and I rushed to see them. It was Eugénie Grandet and Illusion Perdue. Very, very, very good movies. I highly recommend you watch them if you can. And by Titu Lecoq, I love everything she writes. I had recommended another one in the past years, but recently I also read Les Morues. It's a novel by her, very funny and very much a page-turner and a feminist book. She's fantastic. Then not very funny is La Honte by Annie Ernaux. There are a few I have here. Because I read a lot of Kindle at night when it's all night and dark. It was La Honte by Annie Ernaux. Annie Ernaux, highly recommended because her books are short. They're not always very funny because what she talks about is not funny and she talks about her life. So it is a very dry kind of writing. You might like it or not, it's fine, but she needs to be known. And it's about when one of her parents tried to kill the other and she's hiding it and she's ashamed of it. So she wrote about her dad, she wrote about her mom, she wrote about her abortion, and it was just adapted into a movie I have not seen yet, but I plan to see. But this one, L'Evénement, very, very good as well. In terms of a bit different books, which is not in French, that I loved, and when I was preparing this lesson, I could not find it. I know it's somewhere. I don't know, but it's hidden somewhere. It's La Fin de l'Homme Rouge by Svetlana Alexievich. It was written in Russian, obviously. I love everything she writes. I had loved La Guerre n'a pas un visage de femme, which has completely changed my life. La Fin de l'Homme Rouge is about the fall of USSR and what it meant psychologically and in real life for its people. Great. If you're interested in what it means to have a massive country fall, you have to read this. It's absolutely fantastic, and you understand Russia a little bit better. If you're still here, it means that you're interested in French books, so I can dig a little bit deeper into more niche content. In terms of sociology, I've read quite a bit for a long time. So one of them is this one. It is Mille et une façons d'être juif ou musulman. So as the book says, it's about Jewish and Muslim, Muslims and Jewish in France. So it's really, really, really good because it gives you lots of context about what it is to be, what is laïcité in France, which can be a bit tricky if you're a foreigner. And Delphine Horviller, again, anything she writes is fantastic, including this one. If you are interested in what it means to be Jewish in France, Réflexion sur la question antisémite, fantastic. Then in terms of classes, I read Où va l'argent des pauvres? Again, mind-blowing. It changes your life if you're interested in this area in France, by Denis Colombi. Absolutely great. It's going to tell you about the French system as well. If you don't know anything about it, it's great. If you know a bit, it's going to open your mind a lot. And in terms of money as well, Le genre du capital, about feminism and money, mind-blowing. Again, you see everything differently after reading it. It's by Cécile Bessière and Sybille Golac. This is very niche. You need an advanced level of French and a bit of a level of knowing the system of France and be interested in the money. Okay, so it's not for everybody, but if you're into it, you'll thank me because they're fantastic. I talked about what it means to be Jewish and Muslim in France, something very interesting that I read recently because of the rise of extremisms in France. En finir avec les idées fausses sur la laïcité by Nicolas Cadenne. It's very interesting because it also compares what laïcité means in France compared to other countries in Europe and the US and other countries in the world. So that is very interesting because it gives you what the law was made for and what it means in terms of being open for religions. And so that was really good, and it really compares with what ignorant people are saying about it in order to bring hate in the country. Again, in terms of sociology, a fantastic comic book, because this one is a comic book. It's called Riche, Pourquoi pas toi? By Mario Montaigne, Monique Charlot-Pinson, and Michel Pinson. Great, it is a comic book. I didn't expect to read because a friend of mine borrowed it at the library. And she said, you have to read this, and I loved it. And I discovered Monique Charlot-Pinson and Michel Pinson through that book. And then I read Les Ghettos du Gotha. So it is all about what the richest classes are, what they mean in terms of different kinds of power and the different kinds of power, what they are. It's money, it's a status, it is a family, it is a power, occupation of space as well. So great, like, oh my God, it's so good. Les Ghettos du Gotha is even more niche. So that's really for some people who are interested in how the space is occupied, especially in Paris. So if you're interested in Paris, that is a really good book. My dad is currently reading it. He really likes it. If you like the rich areas of Paris, you will understand better how they are built and how they've been going through history. Really good book. If you're still there, we're going to move into more feminist books. So the first one is Les Femmes aussi sont du voyage. It is such a page turner as well. And when you read this one, you want to read 10 more books about the women who are talked about in the book. It is by Lucy Azema. It is about women travelers of all ages, from all eras, and the awesome things they did, and you just want to read more. So that's a bit of a trap, because everybody who finishes it ends up with a list of 10 to 15 books to read after that, but that's very exciting, and you just want to take your bicycle and go. Et les femmes se sont levées was a complete surprise, because I picked it in a library, no, in a bookshop. That's what you say in English, in the bookshop in Alsace. And it is by Marie-Josée Masconi, and it tells the story of resistant women, les femmes de la résistance in Alsace. Okay, so in the eastern France, next to Germany. And to tell you the truth, I was biting my lips in the car when we were coming back from there on holiday, because I was didn't want to cry and sob in front of my son in the car. So I was reading it and was like biting my lips because it was very emotional, obviously. And it's real stories. They're short stories of each woman. And it is, again, really, really good. But I'm going to say that about each book. Fille by Camille Laurens. It's been talked about a lot in France as well. It is about the destiny of a young woman up to now and how the society impacts her. I cannot say too much about it because it's very difficult to describe, but it is really, again, the story of a girl who grows up more in the countryside, let's say in the 1960s, 70s, and everything that seems very classic happens to her, but in a bad way, and then she grows out of it. And it was hard at the beginning because it's tough, but then you go into it, and I wanted to read it because so many women said it really went into their heart, that I agreed it was really strong, but a bit depressing, but the end is a bit better. In terms of travel, it's a book that my friend Christina from Speak English with Christina, who is my friend, she's a big cyclist, and she lent me this one. So that's Le Guide du Vélo au Féminin à vos cycles, and great book. So if you like cycling or traveling, even not alone, but camping and all, that's a really, really good book. It gives stories about women who travel by bicycle. And even if you're a beginner like me, you will really enjoy the short stories about them. And at last, the big, big, big books that everybody's talking about at the end of November is Les Strates by Penelope Bageux. Penelope Bageux, super, super famous comic book writer. It's about her story, her life, and it's about extracts of her life. And it's like a journal, because that it has the format of a journal with the elastic and all. And it's really nice to read. I didn't expect to like it that much, but I really did, because what she talks about talks to everybody. And it's easy to read because it's a comic book, so you have all the images as well. And yeah, I really enjoyed it. And several of my friends are already on the reading list, and I had to tell one of them, I want to film a video with it. Can I get it back for a day, please? And she said, okay. You can have it back. And if you're here, it's really because you love books. And the ones that really challenged me the most this year was about the treatment of children. And some mind-blowing books came out this year that I really want to talk about because they are so important. And you understand much more what is happening right now in France in terms of the feminist movement and the children abuse. How can I say, fights that are happening right now in the media and in the church as well. All this is extremely important. The first is La Familia Grande. I didn't expect to read it. I had heard lots about it, and I was not ready, but then I jumped because I wanted to know what it was about. It's by Camille Kouchner. And the thing is, it's about a very famous man who had been abusing his stepson. And the stepson is from a very famous family as well. So it was a bomb in France when it came out, because it involved lots of super famous people who knew what was happening and didn't do anything. And because now I have a son as well, I'm even more touched by this kind of books. It's intolerable. It's just impossible to bear, but it is happening, and we have to keep our eyes open to protect other children from this happening. So La Familia Grande, if you know a bit about French media, it's a really good book because you kind of identify what's happening around the book. And this came from Le Consentement, which I read after, but it was written because this book was written. Le Consentement by Vanessa Springora. Again, a book that should not exist because the authorities should have protected this teenager. She was abused by a very famous French author who wrote about this, and no one did anything about it. Again, just a mind-blowing book about the system of children abuse among very famous people who attract this kind of teenagers. We've had other stories come out in the media recently, which are just the same. But the book really was a bomb that created La Familia Grande because she allowed herself to write it after reading it. So, a very good book. And to finish with the worst one, it's going to blow your mind. It's Le Berceau des Dominations. This one is really awkward because I recommend it, but it's absolutely awful. But again, that just changes your mind on how children are treated in France. And probably around the world, unfortunately. It's Le Berceau des Dominations by Dorothée Ducy. This is about the protection of incest crimes in France. It's, again, it's mind-blowing, and it's such a tough topic where very few people are doing anything about it that Dorothée Ducy gave up on her research after writing the book because nothing was changing, and now she's being more and more interviewed because her book is just perfect. It explains everything very, very well. And she's been into a podcast called Ou peut-être une nuit, and that's how I found her. This podcast, again, tough, but so, 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 so good. Everybody who, it was my sister-in-law who recommended it to me, and we just keep talking about it. And with my friends, with everybody listen to it. And this book is absolutely mind-blowing. So this is not the most funny topic. But if you're still here, it's because you're interested in French books. And if you want something where you're going to say, wow, that was really good. These ones are really, really good. So I don't know if this kind of video is popular. I just do one a year for those who are really into books like I am. Let me know which ones you're curious about reading, the ones that you read as well. You can comment and I will be very, very interested into knowing your thoughts about it. If you love other books that you want to recommend to other people, do it as well. And I wish you a lovely day. I'm going to put right here another book recommendations that I made in the past, and so you can get more books once you're done with all of these. I wish you a lovely day, and I will see you next time. Allez, salut.